Have you heard of the Pareto principle, or otherwise commonly known as the 80-20 principle? Let's talk about it today. Hello everyone, I am Ajinkya and you're listening to the Be Productive series, where I make one video every day to help you guys to be more productive and to help you to be better versions of yourself. And what we are going to talk about today is the Pareto principle. Now, it is something which is very interesting, very commonly known as the 80-20 principle, which otherwise translates into 80% of the output that we have, 80% of the output of the things that we do is resulting due to 20% of the actions, 20% of the input that we do. Or in other words, of all the actions that we do in a day, and if we are able to have, let us say, if we are able to do 100 things, then 80 of these things are really done by the 20% of the work that we put in, while the rest of the 80% work that we do, we generally end up getting the 20%. Now, these percentages can vary depending upon different fields, different works, but this is something which has stayed more or less true, more or less consistent throughout the throughout different things. For example, if you take a book, then 20% of the book pages, 20% of the book's content is going to give you 80% of the value, and also the otherwise. So this remains mostly true about everything that we do about in our lives. The contents of a book, the contents of a theory, the contents of this video, maybe some 20% of this 20% part of this video is going to give you the 80% of the entire message, while the rest in the other way. So it is something which we should really very well know. Now, it is something which a lot of people tell so that you could reflect back and think and consider of improvising on the 80% of the task that you do, which yields only 20% output, and really bring in the important tasks, important work in over there. For example, if you are consciously aware that most of the work that you do results into a very little output, you might want to consider changing your ways, mending your ways, changing the things that you do, so that this whole productivity game goes up, right? At the same time, it is opposite, the inverse remains true in a way, that if you are not able to understand this, and if you keep on doing the way it has been going on, then 80% of the 80% of the work that you do is useless. It's mostly unproductive. There's a difference between being busy and being productive. Now, I would say that during those 80% of the things that you do, you are generally busy, you're not productive. But during those 20%, the top 20% of the things that you do, you're productive. So really reflect back, write down all the things. I generally used to tell this to my students, write down all the things that you do in a day, and then decide which are the most important 20% of it, and then just keep those. For the rest 80%, decide, think, and remove as many of the things as you can, so that your productivity can really increase by multiple fold. And reflect back upon this question, which is, are you busy or are you productive? There's really a lot of difference between both of those. I'm going to talk about that one of those days with you. So that was the little something that I wanted to tell about the Pareto principle with you today. Go back, reflect back upon it. Of course, I'm meeting you again tomorrow. And till then, tata. Bye-bye, sayonara.